Hi Pisces, welcome to the Winds of Jupiter, May 2018 tarot reading. Now Uranus going into Taurus is a really big deal. The outer planets change the big picture of your life, and the inner planets are more personal and temporal changes. Now it's been 84 years since Uranus has been in Taurus, and it'll be there for 7 years. And there's going to be some changes in finances and emotions. But I would recommend that you look in your natal chart and see where Uranus is to see where it more heavily affects you. The planet Uranus is the god of the sky, heavens. It oversees technology, electricity, discoveries, innovations, and most importantly, the unexpected. So there's going to be some twists and turns in the road for all of the zodiac signs. And your spread has a big mix of things. It's really interesting. Now, the rune card that you received is Gable. It's really funny because some months, everybody will get a different card. And then other months, like this month here, I think there was 5 or 6 signs that received Gable. And Gable means gift, giving and receiving. But here, I think the gift here is more like talent and skills. Because you received the Eight of Pentacles as the overall energy card. And this is about applying your talent, applying your skills, having the ability to do something. And that actually means to have power, the ability to do and make action. This is a card about projects and accepting new projects, blowing the dust off some talents that you had and haven't used for a long time, or acquiring some new ones. Now recently the number 8 has kind of hypnotized me because it's like a karmic equalizer. It can create and destroy. I call it energy transmutation, changing something from one form to another. It also brings a balance with the intangible to the tangible, spiritual to materialistic. And that's really important for Pisces, your emotions and cups. And this reading is really bringing in pentacles and earth and being grounded and getting a grip. So this is a good thing. And the Minciati card that I pulled, I made a deck of Minciati cards that can go with any tarot deck. And the card I pulled was Taurus. And Uranus is going into Taurus. So it's saying that there's going to be some unexpected, progressive things that are going to be happening with this Eight of Pentacles, new project, or whatever new opportunities you're going to accept in your life. Now, Pisces are selfless, creative, inspirational, and at times a little delusional, going into a little fantasy. You're very spiritual. Let's just put it that way. And here you have this Taurian energy that's pulling you the other way, where they're an earth sign, a fixed sign, and you're a mutable sign. Taurians can be very stubborn, but they're very steady and very balanced. So this is a really interesting balance of opposing forces. I think there's going to be a little bit of the unexpected, but that's okay. It's always nice to have a surprise once in a while. And not the oh, but the oh, wow, that's interesting. Now the cards on the left, for what you know, you receive the Two of Pentacles and the Page of Cups. Now, the Page of Cups can be you. You know, you have a lot of emotions rolling around, and sometimes it's hard to control them. You're up and down. I wouldn't say you're moody like Gemini. But things just kind of take a little roller coaster ride, and the Page of Cups is like that. But then again, the Page of Cups, if he's doing his job, he's bringing in ideas, news, messages, new things into your life. And here you have the Two of Pentacles. As I said, there's going to be a lot of pentacle cards showing up here. And the Two is about decision, balance, and partnership. But here it's more like juggling these ideas, wondering what you should accept and what you shouldn't, what could be called, and what should be focused on. Either you're deciding on some new paths for some new projects, or you're thinking about a new leg of a project and how you should handle it. Mission statement. You know, make objectives and goals. Hopefully you have a good mission statement. that covers what you're going to actually attack. Now the card's in the center for what is or can be yours. You have the Tower and the Two of Cups. You have another Two card, and this one's about emotions and love, and it's connected back there with the Page of Cups. You have another card that's saying choice, partnership, balance, affection, love, extending it to yourself and extending it to other people. Now the Tower is saying there's going to be some change in circumstances, who you extend it to or how you extend it. I wouldn't say this is a sudden collapse, more than an awakening. You're seeing things with some different eyes. You're seeing relationships with different eyes and maybe some beliefs that are surrounded by relationships. Now the card's next door for your awareness or self-awareness. You receive the Seven of Pentacles and the Judgment card. The Judgment card has showed up quite often in these May readings. It's more like things are culminating and changing, and people are judging themselves as well as other people in their life and what's going on in their life, the surrounding ambiance, the environment. You know, there will be accountability if you were a bad person, or rewards if you've been a kind person. I think there's a lot of review time going on where people are just pausing and saying, well, where am I at and where am I going? And you're judging that. This is a time now to extend forgiveness because it'll be offered and accepted. This is a card of rebirth, resurrection, rejuvenation, refreshing yourself, hitting that reset button. Now the Seven of Pentacles is saying that you sprinkled some seeds around and they're starting to grow. But it's indicating now that there's a gestation period, a time of patience and waiting for things to ripen, waiting for the fruits of your labor to come to harvest. And you know, I think you think, well, that's okay. You know, let me give a little respite time here. I've got some new things coming in, some decisions to make, a little change of circumstances, maybe a little change in your relationships. Now the Future cards are interesting too, because you receive Judgment again. Ten of Pentacles and Ten of Cups. Those are great cards. And then the Empress, Fertility. Now here in the future, this Judgment is saying doing some spiritual purging. You're a spiritual person as it is, and you're a selfless person. You give instead of receive. And here you have that Gable, which is about giving and receiving. Can you find balance with that? Can you give to yourself enough to make sure you have what you need? This is a connection between the celestial and earthly, and that's been the theme through this whole reading. You are celestial and spiritual, and your cards are mainly Pentacles, which is earthly, bringing you back down to earth, making you pragmatic. Now the Ten of Pentacles is there again. It's saying that you did a lot of trials and tribulations and now you feel comfortable. Ten is the number of endings and new beginnings. This card is a retirement card, saying that you feel fulfilled. Not everybody's at retirement age, but at least you're feeling comfortable. And the Ten of Cups too, happiness for family card. Seeing a glimpse of heaven over the rainbow of cups. Finding life simple, so you can accept the simple joys of happiness. And the Empress really does epitomize the Eight of Pentacles card of having a new project, because she is about fertility and harvest. And I think there is going to be some rewards in the future at the end of this path. And I wish you acceptance, peace, and happiness.